Hi and welcome. In this video, I will be showing you how to solve quite a specific problem. In some cases, you want to create a single record for a particular date. For example, you want to record reading activities throughout the day, and you don't want to have a lot of records here, 10 minutes, here 20 minutes, and so on. So you want to have one record for each day. And in this video, I will show how to do that.
So the task is that we need to create a single activity for a certain date and then update the information in this record for this exact date. So let's start with creating the date itself. Let's add the temporary variable to the collection. We will call it, it's going to be a date, and we will call it a temporary date, TMP date, current date. And let's create the interface how to manage this date. So we will add the text here. Let's make it a bit smaller. Center it. And in this text label, we will display the current date from this user field. So it's logged in user. TMP current date. Then let's set buttons to increase and decrease the date by one day. It will be an icon button, first one, and the second one here, and change them to arrows. So this will be a right arrow. And this will be left arrow. And by pressing this button, we will add an action that we increase the date by one. So we update logged in user, and we take TMP current date and increase it by one. And we do the same with this button, but we decrease it by one. Logged in user. Okay. We also need to initialize the variable. So let's update the logged in user. We'll attached to this button, we will set the TMP current date to start of today. So it's start of today. And we would like to display this date not as a relative, but as an absolute. So make it date format a date. Let's check how it works. So we have the date, which is increased and decreased. All is working fine. Then we need to create a collection for the activities. So let's add a new collection. Let's call it activities. And let's add properties. So we have a name which is not used. We need a activity date. So we would like to record number of minutes for the activity. So let's add a number and we call it minutes. And probably we would like to link the activity to a particular user. So let's add a relationship to users, and the user can have multiple activities. Great. So then we need to add two components to this My Activities screen. First one is a button to create a new activity, and the second is a list of existing activity displaying a number of minutes and allowing to modify this number. So let's add a button and call it Create Activity. Make it lowercase, and let's add a list of activities, and so we can record the minutes there. So here's the list. it will be a custom list, a list of activities, and here let's display minutes. It's gonna be current activity minutes. We don't need subtitle here, and probably we will need a button to add more minutes. Let's, for the illustration, just use the button add 5 minutes. So okay, and we need to filter this list. We need to filter this list of all activities, not all, but logged in user activities. We need maximum one number of item because we want to have a single activity. And the next filter will be that this activity date equals TMP current date from this logged in user collection. So we will have here displayed all the activities which are recorded for this date. And by adding 5 minutes, we will add an action that we update current activity, and we take number of minutes and increase it by 5. Okay, so we have created the list of activities. We could make it smaller actually, but then we need to create the actual activity, the record. So, and here we will add some logic to this button, and this becomes interesting. So we need to be able to display this, to see this button only when there is no activity for the particular date is recorded. And when there is an activity for this date, this button should be hidden. So we will add the conditional visibility rule. So the button will be sometimes visible. And then we add the condition. When the activities count, so activities count is number of activities, and the user email is equal to logged in user email. So we filter this only for the existing user. And then we add another filter so that activity date is equal to logged in user TMP current date. So what we have here, we are counting the number of activities where the activity belongs to current user, and where the date of the activity is equal to this selected date. And then we add a condition. So if number of such activity is 0, then this button should be visible. And if the number of such activities is not 0, for example, we already have the activity for this date, so we don't need this button to be visible. And by also we need to add the action for this button. So we create the new activity. We are taking the date from the TMP current date from this field. We are adding 0 minutes, and we are adding logged in user as a owner of this activity. So let's test how it works. Okay, get to this page. You see that the button is always visible. So let's create activity for 13th of October. You see, button has disappeared. We can add 5 minutes. We can add more and more minutes. And if we change the date, we see button create activity is visible again. Let's add some activity for 15th of October. So we have the activity here, minutes are recorded. If we change the date and back to 13th, Again, the button has disappeared and we see the activity. Back to 12, the button is here. If we have a look at the database, the activities database will have two records, and you see that they are unique. So the activity date is 15th and 13th, and we have a user who has created this activity. So that's it. Hope you liked it.
Thanks for watching this video. I hope you liked it. Of course, this way to create a single record could be applied in the other cases as well. So you can leave these cases in comments. And if you have any questions, I would be happy to answer them. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel.